Memorial Day weekend, the unofficial start of summer, which means summer vacations finally, and maybe, if you're lucky, a trip to the beach.
Welcome back, beaches!
Oh, we had to share that with you tonight. That was Chicago Mayor Lori Lightfoot opening up beach season, let's be clear, in the Windy City. She made the announcement in a video posted on social media. But before you book anything, whether it's Lake Michigan beaches or somewhere else, we have got a list of the top beaches from across the country. Good stuff there. All right, according to Stephen Leatherman, a.k.a. Dr. Beach, these are the top three beaches in America. Hapuna Beach State Park, that, of course, in the Big Island of Hawaii, Cooper's Beach, Southampton, New York, and Ocracoke Lifeguarded Beach, that is in North Carolina, not too far from the Outer Banks. So Dr. Beach is here with us tonight to explain these picks. Dr. Beach, you have a really fun job.
Oh, well, it's good.
It's good? I'm a little jealous. Okay,
I can't complain.
We love the beach. We love to talk about it. We love to visit. So let's go through your choices and what goes into picking the best beaches. You want to start with the Big Island?
Sure. Hapuna is a special beach. It's surrounded by black lava flows. And when you get there, you're just really surprised. You thought, my goodness, it's like a barren area. And it's like an oasis. The palm trees, the beautiful white sand, the warm water, crystal clear. And in the summertime, like now, you can go swimming, snorkeling, or scuba diving. A lot of tropical fish. This place never disappoints.
A little harder to get to for some of us, especially on the East Coast. So let's a little closer to home for those folks. Cooper's Beach, New York. What's special about this beach?
Well, if you know the Hamptons, it's the playground of the rich and famous. But all the rest of us can go there, too. So I enjoy going there. The parking's kind of expensive, about $40 a day or so. So I just take the bicycle down there. Just rent a B&B and bicycle down. Don't have to pay for parking. But this beach is really pretty. It's a hard-packed beach. And the water is still warm in the summertime. Usually it gets a little bit warmer by July. But you walk along and just beautiful big old mansions. You see that. And, of course, they have lifeguards. They have a nice snack bar. Got everything you want there, and it's a beach to see the rich and famous and enjoy yourself.
Well, it sure is pretty. Let's head down the eastern seaboard now to Ocracoke, North Carolina. Tell us about this beach.
Well, this is a real getaway beach. You don't go there to stay in the Ritz or Hilton even or play golf. They don't have any of that. It's where Blackbeard's old stomping grounds, quite frankly, and so it's a big, beautiful beach. And go to the lifeguarded beach because that's where they have lifeguards and safety thing. But you stay in old inns and B&Bs, and it's just an old village on the bayside, but the beach is beautiful, all to yourself, miles of sand. I like to go seashelling and pick up seashells, and it's just a beautiful place. It's a getaway island is what it is.
A little something for everyone. And that, of course, a special place for me. I grew up in that part of the country, going to those beaches on the Outer Banks. Dr. Beach, thanks for your time. Have a happy and safe summer. And thanks for giving us a few options to plan our summer trips.
My pleasure.
Welcome.
Some great dunes. You've spent some time in North Carolina beaches, too.
Beautiful state all the way around. Mm-hmm. Welcome back, beaches. Well done.
Thanks, Mayor Lightfoot.
We'll be right back.